it's Steph, and today I'm here with something a little bit different. Today I'm going to be doing a product review on some of the things that I received from the website Colourpop. So a little bit of background on Colourpop if you haven't heard of them before. They are this pretty much exclusively, although sometimes they've had pop-ups at physical locations, they're pretty much exclusively an online makeup store that started, I believe, back in 2014, maybe 2013. They started out doing lipsticks, like lip products, and they've expanded to a point where now they offer pretty much everything that you can need for your face, including things that I'll be reviewing today, such as concealer and foundation, as well as a variety of eye products, etc. I have been using their lipsticks and eye products, primarily their eyeshadows, for the past 5 years or so since I've known them. But this is the first time that I've expanded a little bit more outside of that. So there are 6 things that I ordered last time I was on Colourpop's website, and I'm going to be talking a little bit about each of them today. Part of the reason that I'm doing my review on Colourpop is that one of my favorite things about them as a company is a lot of their makeup prices are significantly more affordable compared to a lot of other competitive prices in terms of makeup. I don't have the exact numbers on me right now, but I will make sure to put up on the screen the prices of the makeup that I'll be talking about compared to other brands of makeup that I use as well. So the 6 Colourpop items that I'm going to be talking about today are going to be their All-Star Matte Plus Blur Primer, their No Filter Concealer, their No Filter Foundation, their No Filter Setting Powder, the Ooh She's Blushing Super Shock Cheek, which is a blush, as well as their Volumizing Mascara, which I got in black. Going in order, the first thing that I'm going to be talking about is their primer. It comes in sort of a small-ish tube, which is fine. I believe the price on this wasn't too bad. It goes on pretty easily. It's very soft. It feels a little bit more like a moisturizer in a sense than other primers. The other primers that I've worked with are the Benefit Professional Primer as well as this L'Oreal Primer, and both of those seem to have a bit of a thicker consistency. This one feels a little light, similar to moisturizers, but I feel like it does its job fairly well as far as primers go. Something to note too is that on the back for the directions, they do say to allow it to set for a minute before you apply your foundation. I don't believe the Professional Primer has any instructions like that. This is something that I definitely did while I was putting this on, so I feel like maybe if you don't take this step, it could affect your makeup a little bit, but that's something important to know. Next up, I'm going to talk about the No Filter Concealer, which is this little guy here. The color that I got it in was light 12, sort of creeping into a little bit about talking about the foundation. Something that I thought was really nifty with Colourpop's website is that if you already know your shade in a different brand, so for example, I was color tested at a Sephora for Fenty foundation, so I knew my Fenty foundation shade. You can input that on the Colourpop website in order to find the shade closest to your skin color, as it is, like I mentioned before, a pretty much exclusive online website. It's not very easy to find what your skin tone would be because there's no physical store to go to swatch test against your own skin. So that was something that I thought was really nifty with their website. Coupled with that, with the foundation, the concealer was automatically recommended because of the foundation that I had. So this is the one that was recommended to me. I will have a little video blurb of me trying it on here, but as you can see, it is pretty light compared to my skin color, but it does have a tendency to oxidize a little bit after a couple of seconds when it's sitting on your face. It does blend out fairly nicely though, and I feel like it does a pretty good job. I don't typically use concealers very much, but I do appreciate this one. For the foundation, like I mentioned before, you can color match online. The shade I have here is light 60. I feel like it's just a little bit too light for my face. It did mention on the website that this was not an exact color match for my skin compared to the Fenty foundation that I had been using. It did note that it does have a bit of a cooler skin tone to it, which is something that I definitely noticed when I was putting it on, but I didn't think it was too much of an issue, honestly. It's a little bit off, but I feel like once it was able to blend in and oxidize a little bit, especially with contouring, I feel like it matched my skin well enough. Additionally, this is something that I tried to apply first using an oval brush because I've been super loving using an oval brush, but I feel like this definitely applies so much better if you use a makeup sponge. So when you're applying this, I would highly recommend using a beauty blender over anything else. With the brush, I felt like it sort of got caked on and it was a little bit streaky, so it blends a lot better when you're using a beauty blender. Last but not least, for the face set, I used the No Filter Setting Powder, and I feel like using this coupled with the concealer as well as the foundation really tied together my entire face. I don't think I would use one part of the set without all the others. Minus the concealer, I might use the concealer and mix that with the NYX foundation that I use most of the time, but I definitely would not use the foundation without the setting powder. I feel like the setting powder, using that and blending that on top of my foundation with a makeup brush, I feel really solidified and made my face look really matte. Without it, I feel like because it is a liquid, my face still had a little bit of that liquid sort of look to it, and I feel like the no filter setting powder really like set my face and made it look good. So I would highly recommend that if you do get the foundation, I would highly recommend getting this. I do have a bit of a combination leaning towards oily face though as well, so this I feel was something that was especially necessary for me. Next up, I'm going to talk about this Ushi's Blushing Super Shock Cheek. I have gotten a highlighter from Colourpop before, but I've never gotten a blush, but this one I found was super nice. I'm actually wearing it right now along my cheeks and on my nose. I love pink tones, and the photos that I saw of other people wearing it looked super nice, but it's a super creamy consistency. It's very nice. If I get a little bit on my finger, you can see it's super bright. It was sort of hard to like get onto my brush, but it has a nice color and it blends super nicely. I found that blending in a circle really helped. I would apply it with a brush, obviously, but it's super nice. It's really easy to build on to make it brighter. So I love this a lot. I am leaning more towards doing looks such as these, where I have sort of a airbrushed pink sort of look, I suppose, is sort of what I'm gearing towards. But as far as blushes go, I feel like this one works really well for my skin tone, and I super love it, and I want to try to incorporate it into as many looks as I can, but I highly recommend this one. And the very last item that I'm going to review is a volumizing mascara in the shade Black on Black. I don't use mascaras too often. I do have, I believe it's just a Sephora brand mascara that I typically use in a dark purple burgundy sort of color. And I only typically use it on my bottom lashes because most of the time I am using fake lashes on my upper lash line. But for situations like these where I'm still wearing my glasses and I have makeup on and I don't wear fake lashes, I feel like this is really good. Again, this is something that I'm wearing. I'm actually wearing all these ColourPop products on my face. The volumizing mascara, I feel really does its job, but you can kind of see how my bottom lashes super stick out, and I mean, I don't really have any crazy top lashes, but I feel like it really does a good job making your eyelashes look super dense and really pop. I believe in the video here, you can kind of see the difference. It definitely, in terms of comparison, makes your eyelashes pop a lot more. So overall, I felt pretty satisfied with my purchase. I'm still kind of getting used to the ColourPop products for the face, but I feel like once I figure out exactly how to apply it, it'll be pretty good. I think it's a fairly decent alternative for other makeup. There is cheaper makeup out there, such as lines like NYX, but for example, Fenty can be a fairly expensive foundation, and I feel like this is fairly close enough that it's a good product to consider and at least try out. If anything, the products aren't too expensive, so it's not like you're investing in something that'll be a huge loss if it does wind up being a miss. I don't really know if ColourPop has any return policies. Overall, their Super Shock Pigment Anythings, whether it comes to their eyes or their blushes, I feel is always spot on. Super highly recommend any sort of pigmentation like that from them. If you haven't tried them yet, I highly recommend trying them. Their mascara was also surprisingly good, and I know that they do also have it in a wide variety of colors as well, which is super useful if you're doing cosplays from super colorful anime. I think like Hoseki or Land of the Lustrous has some pretty intense colored eyelashes, as well as JoJo, I believe. So ColourPop, I would highly recommend to anyone that cosplays from that fandom. Same sort of thing goes for their lip products, which I can do a review on at some point if you guys are interested. Hopefully this video is super useful for any of you that are unfamiliar with ColourPop's makeup and you're sort of on the fence about whether or not you should invest in it. I definitely say go for it. I was a little afraid that because it was such a low price point, the makeup would be a little bit cheap, but I do like it a lot more than a lot of drugstore makeup. So if you're unsure of where to start, I would highly recommend taking a look at ColourPop first. Also, one little note, if you don't know what your skin tone is and you don't have some other product because ColourPop might just be the first foundation that you ever get, the best way that you can figure it out is if you go on ColourPop's website, it'll ask you to cross compare with a couple different brands depending on if you're getting liquid foundation, and they also have a foundation stick. Whichever one you kind of want, or if you want both, both of them. I would recommend taking a look at the brand that they cross compare with. I can put a little list here of those brands and maybe writing them down or taking note of it, and then going to a store such as Sephora, or I know NYX also does it as well, or I think if you go to like a department store or something, they might be able to match you for your foundation shade there. I would recommend going there and approaching a makeup sales associate and asking them for their help, because they should be able to color match you and find what shade should work for you, and that should in turn help you figure out what shade to order from Colourpop's website. If there's anything else you want me to review in terms of makeup, especially from Colourpop, or if you have any other questions, comments, concerns, anything like that, make sure to let me know in the comments down below. If you're new here, make sure to subscribe. If you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. Hopefully it was informative and educational and all that jazz. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next video.